What's going on, everybody? We're here at QuestCon 2017 with my man Stephen Moore. How you doing today, Stephen?
Very well.
Awesome. Stephen is here with, and I'm going to show you guys because I didn't want to just pop it off in the video first. I'm going to just scale over here real quick. Gnome Legends. Check that out. Check that artwork out. I like it. When I look at it, it reminds me of a few things. It puts a few things in my perspective. I see an elephant. I see a cool rad guy. I see these military belt buckles on the sleeves. Shoulders reminds me of Cable. It gives me so many different things, and it gives me that good woodland creature that you would see in something that has something to do with gnomes. Where did you get the idea for this?
Years ago, with University of Alabama, I did some advertisement artwork for them.
Uh-huh.
So I had pictures of warrior elephants.
Okay.
And in my world, people who use a lot of magic, they transform over time.
Okay.
So I figured, what the heck, I dragged that character into my world.
Awesome. So just being a part of the University of Alabama gave you that startup character to bring into your world.
Yes.
Now, I understand that you have a book. Let's check that out real quick.
It's Gnome Legends.
Okay. Let's check this out, guys. Gnome Legends, the book. So tell us what the book is about.
A boy king, well, actually he's a prince. His family gets killed. He goes into exile, and the story, first book is about him and the people protecting him trying to come of age to where he can eventually take back his kingdom.
Right.
And then the story mainly concludes in the second book.
Okay. Now, I know you have something else that you showed me, and it's for people who cannot draw, and it's titled The How-To Book for Artists Who Can't Draw. I am an artist who can't draw. I think of myself as an artist. I create content. I do things, but I can't draw. Not a lick. I still draw stick men.
I have people.
I still draw the guys with the big shoes. Now, if you ask me to draw a lake scene with the sun and a tent, I can do that all day. Do that all day. But the actual art of drawing and caricatures and faces, I can't get it. So how did you get started in drawing? Was it something you started as a child?
I had an uncle who used to give me comic books all the time.
Okay.
And I just started copying the pictures and that. So I learned to draw from a lot of different comic books.
And there's a lot of people like that who they got some type of media or some type of book that gave and opened up that extra block in their mind to say, wait a minute, I can do this.
Right.
And you know, we all have God-given talents, and that's what's amazing about people. So,
and this book is for the artist or for a person who literally thinks they cannot draw. Because there probably are a few people, but almost anybody should be able to learn to draw. And this is to get you started and the confidence to where you can then pick up a how-to book and not be scared of it.
Well, I'm not going to be scared of this. I'm actually going to work on this, and I'm going to keep connecting with you and show you. Now, my wife can draw. She can draw. She's a teacher, so she's always creating things for her classroom. And instead of going out and buying stuff, she'll create stuff for her own and laminate it. And keep going. Like right now, she's working on, you know how you have those big easel flip books?
Yes.
She's working on one of those where she's doing each alphabet, and she's drawing different things to match the alphabet. Like for A, she has big, beautiful red apple. So
right.
she can actually really draw. So we're gonna work on this, baby. We're gonna work on this. We're both gonna be drawers. So where can we find everything about you at?
Okay, well, I have a website. It's www.grimtrojan.com.
Okay.
But you can also find my books on Amazon.
On Amazon as well. And you're seeing that Grim Trojan website right there on the screen, guys. We're here at QuestCon 2017. Thanks for allowing us to interview, man.
Thank you.
You guys have a good one.